Right, everybody, this is Mr. Fugu with Mr. Fugu's Data Science. I would like to say that all this information will be provided on my GitHub, which is right here, Mr. Fugu Data Science. It'll also be in the description for a link in the video. We're doing a continuation of the last video where we generated dummy or fake data using R in the Jupyter Notebook. Here's a brief piece of the last few entries of that file. Mind you, this is dummy data, it's not real, there's no security or privacy concerns. Okay, we have credit card, email, first, last name, and a primary phone number. If you don't remember how we did this, there will be a link to the other video as well. Okay, I need you to open up your terminal and enter MySQL. I'm using a Mac with an installation via Homebrew. So for me, I open up by MySQL.server and then start. And then before we get started, if you've never created an alternate user profile, you're gonna need to do these other steps. So you first log in to your MySQL root. From there, you will need to create a new database with whatever database name you have and always end with a semicolon. Now you're creating a user with whatever username inside of single quotations at single quotation localhost, and then you're identified by some password you create. Now you're doing a separate call, so you say you're granting all privileges on whatever database you just created dot star to your username at localhost, and you need to flush all privileges. Now feel free to pause the video and spend a minute or two logging in and setting this up if necessary, and I could wait. All right. So I'm assuming that you've logged in, you either created or have an existing user other than root. Before we get started, I need to note that if you get an error while loading data from R to MySQL, you may have this. It'll say a loading local data error. And you're like, what the heck is this junk? So you say, all right, you go on Stack Overflow and you find something. And it'll say, all right, log in as your root account. After you log in, you say, show global variables like, and then you're looking for the local in file. And you'll get a printout in the terminal that looks like this, and it'll be off. So then now you have to turn it on, and you say, all right, set global local in file equal to on. And that'll fix it. Now, I'm not sure if this is going to fix it only temporarily while you're making the connection call or if it's permanent. And if it's not permanent, you're going to have to change, I think, the config file. There is a link for Stack Overflow that gives like a semi-brief explanation. I may need to look into that. So for the table that we're creating, I decided to call it user info for this first example. We're going to also have another example. This is loading. What we are creating in the first example is a data frame. We're loading data directly to MySQL. The second one is a CSV file that we dumped from R that we will load into MySQL. That's the distinction here. So what we're going to do is go to my terminal, and I already have this set up. But let's do it as if you're doing it. So we're looking at all the tables I have. I need to drop this for mine so we could be on the same page. Table. All right. Now after we drop that table, we're going to say, all right, let's create this table. Because this is a step where you basically should be, since you don't have a table like this. So, we Now we got it. Now let's see what's inside of it. All right, here's what we have inside. We have a primary key initiated by an ID that auto increments. We have a primary phone number, which are ints. First and last name is varchar, or varchar for the last name if you had like hyphens and stuff like that. First name, and then email and credit card. Okay. So you're going to need to set up a driver that looks for MySQL. We're going to set up a connection where we're doing a DB connect, and then your MySQL. You're setting up whatever your database is that you created. You're setting up your localhost, and then your user information for your login and your password here. Okay. Then we could look at the info and say, okay, this is my user that I have. This is the database I'm in, just a version of MySQL, whatever this stuff is. Okay. When you're writing your table from R to MySQL, you can do an overwrite equals true, where append will be false. And this is creating a database no matter what. Whereas if you're doing the converse, it would be overwriting is false and you're just appending only. Okay? So what we're doing is you're saying your connection, your con is equal to the connection you set up above. We're going to overwrite equals true, append equals false, and our data frame is called users that we're using, and we're going to send it to our info. Good. Now, we have a valid connection, and this is how many connections we have to MySQL. This starts incrementing, if I'm correct. So then basically, there's a few things. You could do a send query, which basically gets the query, but it doesn't procure any information. It just does a pure query call. You can do a fetch, which actually takes the data from MySQL, imports it into R. You could store it and actually manipulate and use that data. But at the end of that call, you need to do a DB clear result. Otherwise, you end up getting an error. You also have a get query, which by default calls your send query, followed by a fetch, allowing you to be free from the call of the DB clear. I provided a link to the description through the R from an R document. We're going to do... Let's just look at some simple queries. One, proof of concept. Two, see what we could pick up. So I did a select all from the user user info. This one worked because I already have an established connection to that as well. We have... the first three people with the first name of Samuel. Okay, that's great. So it shows that we can actually do some queries, which is perfect. This lists what fields there are. So we have credit card, email, first name, last name, primary, and then your row numbers. Let's see, using the DB fetch, what happens? We get a true. Oh, okay. Let's find our data. So basically what I was doing is I was using the above query, sending it to fetch the data so we could actually store it here. You also have options such as extracting chunks and extracting all the remaining data. And then we can do a disconnect when we're done with everything. But I'm going to leave it open real quick so we can now set up a .csv that's inside of R that we created and dump it to MySQL. So what I had to do to figure this out, since I couldn't find very much documentation, I basically hard coded and figured out what the path was. There would be an easier way using like an OS import from Python that you can do from a package, but for simplicity, we'll just paste this in, dump the file, use the connection, overwrite true, row name's false, name of where we're going to send it, and then append equals false. Perfect. Now, let's do a query and say, okay, perfect. This looks like it's working. We have proof of concept. We have query. Let's also add now and append to this file, which is the table of user O that we just created. Let's add a primary key. All right. So let's see. And then now we print it out, and now we have an ID, which is the primary key. So then we go over here, and we say, if we notice, we didn't have that new table. So let's look at show tables. So here's the new table that we just added. Let's do... describe that table. Now shows everything that we just added from inside of R, and shows that we just provided an update of a primary key. Now everybody, I want to say thank you for watching this video. The next video I will do is Postgres from R, and in subsequent videos, I will go from Python to MySQL and possibly Mongo or Postgres. But I appreciate you watching this video. Please like and subscribe. And as always, have a good one. Thank you.